Well, the state finally took action to stop the flow of public dollars to an addiction recovery nonprofit at the center of Care 11's investigation into Medicaid billing irregularities. Here's AJ Legault with the latest developments in Recovery, Inc.
Citing credible allegations of fraud, DHS is now withholding all payments to Refocus Recovery. The nonprofit and its for-profit partner, KARE, have been under state and federal investigation for months, yet have been allowed until now to continue billing Medicaid millions of dollars.
So why don't you take a look at 4-5?
You don't need 20/20 vision to spot what Holly Malchek calls fraud.
No, it did not happen.
Billed to her Medicaid insurance.
No, this is blatantly obvious.
Several months ago, Holly noticed suspicious bills by Refocus Recovery, which claimed to provide her with thousands of dollars of peer services to help her in her addiction recovery.
Any sense of how much is legitimate?
None. I didn't know that I was being billed for any of these things.
Holly reported the suspected fraud to her insurance company. She also contacted Care 11.
My name is Daniel Larson, and I'm the CEO and founder of KARE.
She'd seen our reporting that exposed how a man named Daniel Larson founded both a tech company called KARE and the nonprofit Refocus Recovery, and used the nonprofit to funnel millions of tax dollars into the for-profit by paying KARE to provide addiction recovery services.
Some of it's just flat out lies.
After client.
Some of the events were just like made up.
After client told us were not provided as claimed.
It's not even like excessive billing, it's fraudulent billing.
KARE's reporting led to legislative reforms, and in February, DHS's Inspector General said this.
DHS can confirm the existence of an ongoing investigation regarding KARE and Refocus Recovery.
But taxpayer dollars continued to flow. The latest available DHS data shows during the first half of this year, Refocus Recovery was paid $5.5 million.
This letter shows the free flow of payments stopped on September 6th. DHS cited credible allegations of fraud that Refocus Recovery billed for services not provided, submitted claims not entitled for reimbursement, and failed to provide supervision as required.
All made up.
Holly's records could be a case study. Example, on April 5th, Refocus Recovery billed taxpayers claiming KARE provided Holly 2 hours of peer services from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. at her Rochester home.
It says it happened at my house. But no, it did not happen.
To back that up, Holly has texts that show the KARE peer reached out to her just after they'd allegedly spent hours together asking, "How are you today?" To which Holly replied, "Hi, I'm feeling pretty good so far today. How are you feeling?" And that's just one example.
Where were you on August 24th?
I was in Cokato, Minnesota, attending my son's wedding.
Photos from the day show her dancing with her son. But KARE and Refocus records show she was billed as if she was at home, 3 hours away, attending a support group.
Impossible.
Neither KARE nor Refocus responded to our interview requests. While Refocus can no longer bill Medicaid, KARE is now sending out emails to clients like Holly, asking them to sign waivers that would allow KARE to just keep on billing for them under the name of a different nonprofit. However, the CEO of that nonprofit, Twin Cities Recovery Project, emailed me today that they are not moving forward with a KARE partnership. For Care 11 Investigates, I'm AJ Legault.